Okay, Comp One. Here we are in the final essay. So we've this whole class, there's four total essays. You've handed in three. Now it's time to get the last one done and finish strong. So this is the argumentative essay. So it's a straightforward argument. And the goal is to make an argument that is believable to your audience. In essay three, we analyze someone else's argument. And we were able to say, hey, this was something that probably will make the argument more believable for the audience, or maybe this might make the argument less believable for the audience. Now we've studied other people's arguments. Now it's time to make an argument for yourself. So I'm going to go ahead and share my screen with you. And let's see here. Let's go ahead and take a look at what we're doing here. So this is Comp 1, English 101. And I'm going to go over the requirements for this assignment. It is really important that you get all of the assignment requirements, especially on this one, because there are some things that I do specifically to limit you to what you can write about. And the only reason I do that is because I've done this for years, and it never fails. If I just say, write about whatever you want to write about, there'll be somebody out there who writes about aliens or flat Earth or something like that. So rather than to do, just rather than to take that chance, I've limited some of the topics you can discuss. However, I don't limit you that much. So we'll talk about it. Let's take a look at this. This is the argumentative essay. It must be 4 to 6 pages long, Times New Roman 12-point font, 2.0 spacing. Now, up until this point in the semester, I have not enforced the fact that you will get a failing grade if you fail to give me a four, at least the minimum page length. And you need to give me at least, it always has to be Times New Roman, 12-point font, 2.0 spacing. And all I've done is I've been very nice this semester because, hey, we're doing this virtually. And normally I'm not as nice, but I've always, this semester, I've just counted a little bit off if you didn't give me the right format. But since this is the last essay of the semester, I will have to enforce this because I need to make sure that people that pass this class understand the basic formatting of essays. 12-point font, Times New Roman, 2.0 spacing. You have to give me at least four full pages. This does not include the works cited page. Okay, so we always have a works cited page whenever we're using sources, but that does not count as far as your page length. And I talk about that here. So you must also include a works cited page, of course. Just like all the other essays where we used sources, you had to have a works cited entry or works cited entries. Failure to meet these requirements is an automatic failing grade for this assignment. This is worth 15% of your grade. You don't want to have an automatic failing grade. So take this very seriously. So let's talk about choosing a topic for this essay. Again, this is your own argument. You're going to make an argument. So you need to choose a topic, and then you need to say, what is my opinion on it? And now, what is the argument I'm going to convince someone else of? This is not an essay where I'm just saying, hey, tell me what you think about this thing. Okay. No one really cares what I think about this thing, right? What really makes an audience change their mind is whenever the writer thinks about, okay, how am I going to change the mind of someone who disagrees with me? That's your goal. Your goal is not to tell me why you think what you think. Your goal is to tell your reader why your reader should believe the thing you want them to believe. Okay. And that would be your thesis statement whenever you tell me what you believe. So let's see here. So choosing a topic, you've read and understood the required reading list. So when it comes to the required reading list, we're talking about all the readings you've done so far. And then I'm just opening up this to the whole book. So any reading from the book. So you choose one of the required readings to use in your essay. If you would like to use a reading that we have not covered this semester, you may do so. So you can do one of the two required readings that we're doing for this, for your last two summaries. I haven't talked about that yet, but you can choose one of those two, or you can choose any other from the textbook. Now, this is not going to be a thing you're going to respond to. You're not going to copy their argument. You're not going to make the same argument. What you're doing is we're going to use sources to support whatever it is that you're arguing. So you've got this thesis statement, and you're going to need to find evidence to back up your claims. And so one of those pieces of evidence will have to be an article from the book. So this is going to help you choose your topic, because if it's an article in the book, that means you're not going to be able to write about flat earth or, you know, some other thing that, you know, may not, you know, maybe it's a fun thing to discuss, but it's not something that we would necessarily argue in a scholastic setting. So, you know, take a look at some of the topics that are covered, and that should help inform you as to what topics I would like you to stay within. There's a lot of topics in the book. Okay. So it's, I'm not really fencing you in very much. And just remember, all you need to do is use one of the articles as a source to back up something that you're saying in your essay. The topic of your essay will be the same topic as your chosen reading, but the thesis of the essay will be your own. So this needs to be your own argument. This means that you'll make the position, you're going to take a position that agrees with the reading, or your essay can argue a different position. So you can have the same position, but I don't want you writing the same argument, okay? I don't want you writing just a copy off of their article. And then your essay can argue a totally different position, something not even the opposite. It can be just around the same topic. It just remember, it's got to be your argument here. So you're going to support your position. To make this essay complete, you must cite from one of the readings from the textbook. We've already talked about that. You are also required to use at least two sources from the Vincennes University Library resources to augment your argument. The use of other internet sources is not permitted unless authorized by your instructor, that'd be myself. Failure to comply with this requirement will result in an automatic failing grade for this class. So a lot of ways to get an auto fail, right? So here's the thing, you have to use the VU Online Library. I'm gonna show you how to do that. And you have to use at least one source from the textbook, okay? So that's three total sources. And you're not using any other like whatever.coms or things like that from the web, okay? And the thing is, I'm trying to help you get quality sources, and the VU Online Library is a great way to do that. I want you to know how to use that. This is not only gonna help you in Comp 1, and or maybe if you go to Comp 2, of course, it'll help you. But if you take other classes, if you ever have to do any kind of research, it's really important that you know how to do database research. So that's essentially the goal here. You're going to use MLA citation. I'll let you read this. Think about who your audience is. And again, you're going to follow the basic essay format. And I've got videos that I'm uploading. I'll be uploading Monday. I assume most of you guys will watch this Monday. I'll be uploading these videos to our YouTube channel, and then to our Blackboard page to guide you through, again, the writing process, just like I've always done. So that is your assignment. And let's take a quick look. That is your argumentative essay assignment. Now you also have a secondary assignment, okay? And this is worth 5% of your grade. And it's the annotated bibliography assignment. Take a look at that here. So the annotated bibliography assignment, it goes hand in hand with your argumentative essay. So what we're gonna do, an annotated bibliography is essentially, it's a way of documenting your research. It's a way of basically keeping track of all the sources that you're gonna do research with. You're probably not going to simply do just one search and then you're gonna find three sources and you're done. You're probably gonna need to find, you're gonna read some sources. That one didn't work. This one I can't really use. I have no idea what they're talking about here. It's going to take a while before you find all three sources. So once you do find a source that you want to put it in an annotated bibliography entry. So you take a look at this annotated bibliography assignment sheet, and we've got, let's see here. Basically, I give you some instructions on how to do it. It's very, very simple. Essentially, you're going to have a works cited entry, just like you would anytime you're going to cite something, just like you have in the works cited. You're going to have 2 to 3 sentences briefly summarizing the source, just what is the source about, and be specific, because later on you're going to want to come back to it and say, oh, what was this? What did the source talk about? Oh, right. I have a little bit of a summary that's specific. What are the main points, right? And then you're going to need 1 to 3 sentences explaining why your source is a good source for your essay. To do this, you should use the criteria on the crap sheet located in essay 4. Let me show you where that is. Oops, that's not right. Here we go. The crap sheet in essay 4, the essay 4 project materials folder. It's right here. It's in the annotated bibliography folder. It's the crap test, source evaluation materials. You take a look at that. This is something to read to say, okay, is this a good source? Is this a quality source? Is this something that I feel comfortable going in front of professionals and using this as a source? Or is this something that people are gonna laugh at, not take seriously? Maybe it's even gonna make me look bad because I used a source that just wasn't good for my assignment. Now, fortunately, all of your sources in this assignment must be from the VU Online Library or the textbook. So it's likely that those sources are gonna be quality sources. It's just up to you to figure out why. So what I want you to do is use the vocabulary here. This particular source has currency because it was published in the last 2 years. This particular source is very relevant to my topic because it is specifically intended for the audience that I'm writing to. Okay, so think about, take a look at this and think about how these sources that you're looking for, how they apply, how does that all work? Okay, going back to the assignment sheet, and you're gonna need 1 to 3 sentences explaining how you plan to use the source in your essay. This is pretty simple. You could say, I plan to use this source to prove X, Y, and Z point, right? Whatever point that you know you're gonna need to prove and you're gonna need some evidence. Okay, I'm gonna use this source to prove this thing. Or maybe you're gonna say, I'm gonna use this source to overcome my a likely objection to my argument in my refutation paragraph. I plan to use it in my refutation paragraph. Or maybe you're gonna use the source and say, I'm gonna use this source to provide some context, some historical context, so my audience understands some fundamental point that they need to understand in order to understand my argument more effectively. However you plan to use it, just write a sentence, to 1 to 3 sentences telling me how you plan to use it. And I've given you some examples below. So here's a few examples down here. They're not perfect examples. I would say that this student got a B plus, which is pretty good, right? So these are pretty good examples that you can take a look at below. This is approximately what your annotated bibliography will look like. You'll notice there are 3 sources here. So there you go. Now let's talk a little bit about sources. Specifically, let's take a look at your homework for this week since we're just getting started, but there's a lot of stuff I wanna throw at you. I need to throw at you right now. If we go to, let's go to the syllabus, and we're gonna take a look at the readings for this week. So these are the 2 readings you will need to summarize. And let's see here, we're gonna go down to week 12. Wow, we are blazing through this semester. Almost done with it. It's just about Christmas time, right? Well, maybe not, maybe we got a little time. So here we go. So week 12, we're gonna review Aristotle's 3 appeals so you can use them in your argument. So in the last essay, I assigned you a reading that covered Aristotle's 3 appeals. I also, in the last essay, in essay 3, that folder, there are 3 videos covering each one of Aristotle's 3 appeals. So you're gonna wanna take a look at those. And because this is your secret sauce, this is how you will appeal to the people who are reading your argument. This is how you appeal to human beings. You're gonna complete your brainstorming, clustering, and free writing for essay 4. And you're also gonna complete the audience awareness paragraphs for essay 4. Now, and then you're gonna start on your outline. So a lot of things for essay 4 is gonna happen this week. So you really need to use your time wisely this week. I really want you to think about, what will you argue? What is the argument that you're going to make? Because you really need to know that. You need to figure out what it is you're going to argue very quickly. So if you've waited past Monday to watch this, you know, you've shrunk the amount of time that you should have been spending. You really do need to think, what am I going to argue? What is the thesis statement I'm going to make? What is this argument that I'm going to make to my audience and try to convince them of whatever it is that I think that they need to believe? This is kind of a natural, this is a pretty, it's one of those things where it's easy to come up with an argument, it's usually pretty easy for students to come up with something that they want to convince the audience of. The difficulty is making a college level argument. So that's really the challenge here. But I'm betting, and this is how it is every year, I'm betting that many of you guys, you've been waiting for this opportunity all semester. So most people really like this assignment because it gives you an opportunity to argue something specific that you want to argue. But basically, you're going to be really working hard on essay 3 this week. And next week, by the end of the week, you'll need to have a rough draft completed, okay? So, you know, we don't have a whole lot of time left in the semester. And this essay does require some hard work. But at this point in the semester, you should know how to do the writing process. We've done this enough times. Brainstorming, clustering, free writing, audience awareness paragraph, outline, you know, the peer review process. We've done this process enough that this is not new. The only thing that you need to think about, okay, we've got some new concepts here. I'm going to make a straightforward argument for myself. Okay, I need to do this annotated bibliography. Okay, that's something kind of new as well. All right, so those are the new things, but these are things that work together. And these are things that you kind of naturally know how to do anyway, which is make an argument. But the difference is we're making an argument that we're going to say things that we want, that we believe that the audience will really take to heart, things that will change the audience's mind. You know, it's not just me telling you why I think what I think, because that's not an argument. Okay, so having said that, later this week, I probably will give you another video just like this one, because I'm for essay four, I'm really going to be giving you a lot of guidance. And I want you to make sure that if you have questions along the way, talk to me early. Talk to me as early as possible, because this essay will go fast. We have 3 weeks to complete this essay. Okay, but by the end of week two here, okay, which is the end of week 13, by Friday of next week, you need to have this essay pretty much done. Okay, so that means you're going to need to do a lot of research. Now, to do research, this is the process. So you go to your MyVU, and over here on the left, you can scroll down, and there's a few different ways to find the library, but right here under instructional, you click there and you'll find library. Okay. And there's a few different ways to use the VU Online Library, but let me show you the quickest and the best way. Rather than to do the VU One or anything like that, you scroll down to Databases A to Z. You're gonna click there and you're gonna scroll down to where it says Academic Search Complete. Okay, and so Academic Search Complete, let me make sure that's really the one I wanna use, yeah. They used to call it Academic Search Premier. Now it's Academic Search Complete. So you're going to click there, and this is how you're going to find your sources. This is actually how I found one of the articles that we read earlier this semester. Now let's suppose we're going to do a search on ecology. Maybe that's the topic. Now here's the thing I want you to think about. If you're making an argument, you need to think about the points you're going to make. So you want to brainstorm, cluster, and free write before you start searching for your sources, because that's going to help you understand what it is that you want to actually search for. Because if all I do is ecology, that's incredibly broad, okay? Ecology, wow, okay. I'm going to have a lot of sources that I can come up with, and they are probably not going to be that great of sources to my argument, because it's just such a huge topic. But if I were going to refine that search and I was going to say, maybe my argument is something about how people need to make major changes in their lives to help the environment or to prevent climate change. Okay, maybe that's my main argument. Well, in that case, I want to brainstorm, cluster, and free write about things that I already know, things that I would already, since it's my argument, I should know something naturally about this topic. So maybe I'm going to say, you know, people should, if they can, they should switch to solar electricity. Okay, maybe I might say, if possible, they should switch, they should recycle. Okay, so maybe that's something. And maybe I'm gonna say, if people can switch to maybe a car like the Prius, or maybe an electric car, that would be a good thing for the environment. Okay, so that's just, you know, and I'm just coming up with these things off the top of my head. But these are things that I would specifically search for. Okay, so maybe I would search for personal solar panels. Okay, because what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to think about an argument to my audience. I'm trying to say, okay, my audience is somebody who, I'm trying to convince them. So I'm gonna try to find some information about solar panels. That's just gonna be one paragraph in this essay about specifically solar panels. My thesis statement is going to be how we all should make major changes in our lives to go green, to help save the environment. That's my main argument. But in my argument, I know I'm going to have to come up with different things to say. One of them is going to be, hey, the average person, if they can, they should buy solar panels. So, okay, so I've done that. I've got that in there. This is how I'm going to find my sources. Now you'll notice there's 70 sources already there. Now that's great because it's not hundreds and thousands, but a few things I'm going to do. I'm going to go over here to the left and I'm going to click full text. That makes sure that anything I find in my search, I can actually read and use. Sometimes these things, they're just blank. So that whittles me down to 45 sources. Awesome. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a look at the publication dates. Now, I'm going to think about this for a second, because remember in this crap sheet, one of the things is currency, okay? Something that makes a good argument is how current that source is. Is it something that's up to date, or is it something that's kind of old and outdated? Well, when it comes to things like solar panels or science, anything that has to do with science or technology, I want the information to be as up to date as possible. So when I look at my list, I don't want to go back to 1997 to, you know, because solar panels were nothing like they are now back then. So I'm going to bring it on up. I'm going to say maybe back, I'm going to bring it in the past 10 years, if anything's been published. And even then, for solar panels, a lot's happened probably just in the past 5 years. But so in the past 10 years, okay, I got my publication dates changed. Now I'm down to 30. Oh, great. Now the next thing I'm looking at over here is the source types. And let me tell you something about source types. If you know a whole lot about the topic, you might want to look at an academic journal or a trade publication. But the average person, we're not scientists. These are pretty much reserved for people who are scientists or who are experts in whatever field that you are researching. So if you're not a scientist, if you're not an expert in solar panels, you're going to want to stick to magazines and newspapers. So I'm going to go to magazines. I'm going to click there and it's going to update. I'm going to go back down. I'm going to add the newspapers. Okay, great. That brings me down to 16 sources. Rather than having to search through the entire internet, I'm down to 16 sources, and they're probably pretty decent sources. So let's just pretend that this first one called Solar Heats Up, that's the source I'm going to go with. Now, the thing is, this has a PDF text and an HTML text. I want to go with the PDF text because that's going to be a better source. It's going to look like it had. It's going to look just like it looked in the magazine or the newspaper. So I'm clicking there. Okay, awesome. And this is the article. Okay, great. Well, I can take a look at this article. Hey, look, these are regular people. This might be something that's good for my essay. Great. Let's just pretend I read the thing and, you know, for the sake of what we're doing, I'm just showing you some things. Let's pretend I read it and I'm like, yes, this is something I want to use in my essay. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do two things. First of all, I'm going to really think about what it is that I'm going to use. Maybe there's a quote, maybe there's a statistic. I'm going to paraphrase a little bit. And then I'm going to say, well, I'm going to need to do my works cited entry. I'm going to need to do my annotated bibliography. So I'm going to pull up a new file here, maybe just a new Word document. And I'm going to make sure the format is correct. So Times New Roman, and I'm 12 point font, double 2.0 spacing. I'm going to remove space after paragraph even. So I know that I'm set. Great. So I'm going to go back to this. And the way I'm going to get the works cited entry from the database is they make it really easy. I don't even have to go to a book or anything. I go over to the right and there's this golden, I call it my golden ticket, but it's this piece of paper. It looks like a piece of paper. And if you hover over it, it says cite, C-I-T-E. You click there and then you're going to see this pop up. And all you have to do is hover your mouse over the middle of it and scroll down. And guess what? MLA format. We've got an MLA formatted works cited entry. Awesome. So all I have to do is copy that. Great, copy. And then I'm going to go to my Word document and then I'm going to do right click. So you have to copy and paste it the right way. So right click, and then you're going to go to the merge formatting. Because if I don't merge formatting, it looks like this. Okay, that's not going to be right. I want it to be like this. I want all the italics to stay put. I want all the quotations to stay put. I want everything to be as correct as possible. So merge formatting, click, beautiful. Now, this isn't done yet though. I need to make sure I have a hanging indention. So to get a hanging indention, I'm going to click at the end of the first line. I'm going to press enter and then tab. And then I'm going to click at the end of the second line, enter. And then I'm going to click at the end of the next line, enter. And look at that. That is a perfectly cited, works cited entry for this source. And it's using a hanging indention. It's very easy to do this. And the nice thing is you've got access to this because you're using the online database. Again, you can always go back and rewatch this section, but you just click cite, find MLA, copy it, paste it the right way, and just make sure you have that hanging indention and you've got a works cited entry. Fantastic. So I'm going to do that. And then if I'm going to do my annotated bibliography, I'm just going to do my paragraph right underneath there. I'm going to read the article, okay, and then summarize it. I'm going to write down maybe a few ways that this particular article is why it's a quality source. Well, you know what? This article was published in 2019 in August. So this is only a, maybe just a little over a year old. So it's very current. So I'm going to talk about how current this source is. I'm going to say this source is a great source for my essay because it's a very current source, meaning that the information is very, very current and very much up to date. I'm going to say it's relevant to my topic because it specifically considers how individuals should be switching to solar. It's not about businesses. And my argument is to individuals. So it's very relevant. And then I could go down all three of these or all four or five, you know, all of these things, but I only need a couple, maybe two or three sentences. And I need to specifically state, make sure you're stating these big words so I can look at, I see what you're doing there. And that way you get your points. Then after that, I'm going to say, I plan to use this in my article to talk about one way people can become more green and more eco-friendly, which is going solar. And I will dedicate a paragraph to talking about solar energy. And I wanted to make sure I had some statistics and some figures to use, and this will work perfectly. And that's my annotated bibliography entry. I've done those three things that are on the assignment sheet, and I've got my works cited entry, and I'm just gonna type that down here, and I've got one, okay? And later on in my essay, I've got my works cited entry. So I can use this, not the other paragraphs I'm going to write or the other paragraph, you know, from the annotated bibliography. I'm going to just leave that on the annotated bibliography, but I've got my works cited entry for my essay. So I can just copy and paste it, done. And I'm done. The cool thing is when you do this, you see these numbers here, you know that the page numbers were 68 to 71. And guess what? It's because you use the PDF file of the source, you can just look what page and you can cite the page. Okay, look, down here, page 70. Anything that you cite from this page was on page 70. If you try to do HTML, this is what the HTML version looks like. Here it comes. Come on, let's see it. Okay, notice how the HTML version doesn't have any page numbers, no pictures, nothing. It's just the text. So you wanna try to avoid the HTMLs if you can. Always go for the PDF full text whenever it's available. Okay, so we've got a lot to do, right? You need to come up with an argument. First of all, you need to have that. So, and then you need to brainstorm, cluster, and free write as far as what are some points that I know that I need to bring up in this argument. Then you're going to research those points and you're going to try to find some sources to help you support those points that you'd like to make. And that is the big thing you're going to want to do. Now, this week, I'd also like you to start on your outline. And the best way to do any of this is do all of it at the same time, really. First, not all of it. Do your brainstorming, clustering, and free writing. Then do your audience awareness paragraph. Who is the audience that I'm trying to speak to? I've got a video that I want you to watch, and it covers that, what I'm looking for. But really, who is the audience I'm looking to speak to? What do they believe? What will make them change their mind? Or at least, why do they believe what they believe? And again, it should never be because they're dumb, because they're stupid and they're bad people. That's not going to get you anywhere. You need to understand your audience and you need to say, okay, what will make this audience change their minds? And if you don't believe they can change their minds, then you shouldn't write the essay because you're just wasting your time. Okay. Don't just write an essay just to be writing an essay. Write an essay that you believe will change someone's mind. Or at least it's possible that they'll change their minds. You can't make someone change their mind, but you can definitely give them what they need to change that position. Okay, so having said that, this week, there's nothing you're gonna need to hand in to me, but there are things that you're gonna really need to start doing and you need to work really hard this week. All of this last essay is a sprint, okay? It is a sprint. because you have 3 weeks to do it. But by the end of week two, you need to have your rough draft done. And the rough draft of your annotated bibliography needs to be done by the end of week two. You got 2 weeks to do this. So it's not a lot of time, but you can do it. I've been doing this for 10 years. And every year, you know, twice a year, I teach a sections of this in the fall, sections in the spring. Every year, everybody does it. And you can too. So you're going to be just fine. In week 14, this essay will be due, and then we're going to start on our final project, our portfolio project. So don't miss out on an opportunity to make a lot of points. This is a lot of points in this project. If you tally up all the points possible, it's about a quarter of your grade, maybe even a little bit more if you consider your peer review. So it's definitely not a time to skip out on doing your homework. It's not a time to slough off. It's a time to really focus and really get serious and then really get into it. So if you have questions about this, if you want to shoot ideas back and forth, or hey, should maybe you're not sure about what to argue or things like that, this is a great opportunity for you to come to my office hours, Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, 8 a.m. to 9 a.m. I'll be in my office, my virtual office. And again, all you have to do is go over here. Let's see. Go over here to the faculty page. So faculty tab. And there it is, my Zoom meeting. Just go to that. And I will be there Monday, Wednesday, Friday, 8 a.m. to 9 a.m. And Tuesdays and Thursdays during the 2 o'clock hour. Sometimes I don't make it to those Tuesdays and Thursdays. But if you email me, I'll make sure to make an appointment with you. I will not leave you hanging. I promise. All right, guys. So one more time, a reminder of everything you need to be working on this week. This week, you're going to review Aristotle's Three Appeals. You're also going to complete your brainstorming, clustering, and free writing, and you're going to complete your audience awareness paragraphs for your essay four. So really, it's just one paragraph. Who is your audience? Who's the audience you're speaking to, okay? And then you're going to begin the outline for essay four. If you haven't already read the assignment sheets, don't just rely on the fact that I read them to you via this message. Make sure to read those yourself and make sure you fully understand the assignment. And if you don't, reach out to me as soon as possible, because I want to make it clear to you. And the clearer it is earlier on, the better you're most likely to do on the essay. Okay, guys, I hope this has been helpful. I appreciate your attention. Guys, have a great week and expect more videos from me throughout the week. Because this essay, I really, you know, it's the last chance for some people to get that passing grade. But for most of you, it's the last chance to get that B or that A, that you've been working so hard for. So keep working hard, guys. Thanks so much. Have a great week. And let me know if I can help you. Just feel free to email me.